This is the school, the primary school that is. Yeah, this is the high school where I once picked up a 9-year-old girl. I think she's 9 years old, who has been sexually abused by her stepfather. Yeah. Now we are entering Sondela, the heart of Sondela now. I think we need to educate the perpetrators. That will, I think, will lessen up this violence.
Nous sommes là en périphérie de Rustenburg, dans la province du Nord-Ouest, en Afrique du Sud, au cœur de la ceinture de platine, région minière hautement lucrative. Ici, on extrait plus de platine que partout ailleurs dans le monde. Nous sommes en route avec Leboang Seketama, l'un des chauffeurs travaillant pour un projet de prise en charge des victimes de violences sexuelles et sexistes menées dans cette zone par Médecins Sans Frontières. Lebo a grandi ici. Il a littéralement du platine dans la bouche.
This tooth it was broken into half. So they told me I can just replace it with the gold or whatever. Then I chose platinum. Then the reason behind the platinum is because of I'm living in the platinum province.
Pour beaucoup de gens qui vivent à proximité des mines, en particulier dans les quartiers informels, la vie est dure. Une étude menée en 2015 par MSF a montré qu'une femme adulte sur quatre vivant dans cette zone avait été violée à un moment de sa vie. C'est pourquoi en 2015, MSF a commencé, en collaboration avec des partenaires locaux, à fournir ici des services de soins de santé sociale et mentale aux victimes de violences sexuelles et sexistes. Pour la plupart des patientes que nous soignons ici, la première personne qu'elles rencontrent est un chauffeur. Et tous ces chauffeurs sont des hommes.
When I take the job, I thought, okay, I'm coming here. Okay, I'm gonna only drive, collect the patient, drop them at the center, then take them back. But now when I'm here, I realize that no, it's more than that. I have to be emotionally invested in this, because if someone will come in crying, telling you what happened to them, you have to listen. Yeah. No matter how it hurts, you have to listen, you have to comfort them. I think drivers have got a huge responsibility in MSF. And you can imagine, I'm a man, the lady has been abused by a man. She has to get inside the car, and sometimes I'm alone in the car with her. So you know how it feels. You have to let her know that she's on a safe place, she's safe with you, then That's how it is. It's emotionally, yes.
Le transport de patients est soumis à un protocole précis.
I greet them, I introduce myself. Then after introducing myself, it will be up to them if they tell me their name or not, it's okay. Then I open the door for them if maybe they need to. And then I tell them, okay, be comfortable. I'm taking you to the place where you will find help. Okay, then start with small talks. If she speaks, then she'll respond. If she's not responding, then I'll just drive.
Le beau sait ce que ses patientes traversent. Quand il était adolescent, sa sœur de 9 ans a été violée par un voisin.
Even now, I know she never went for counseling, you know. And sometimes even when I'm speaking to her, she tries to block that memory from her mind. But I know that thing is still there, like it is on me now.
En 2018, Lebo et les autres chauffeurs ont suivi une formation de premiers soins psychologiques. Voici Poppy. Pendant des années, elle a été mariée à un homme violent. Jusqu'au jour où son mari lui a cassé l'épaule.
As always, as he came home drunk, he pushed me against the wall, and unexpected, then I heard something like something is cracking. I thought, no, maybe it was a mistake. He will never repeat it. and I was lying to myself.
Elle était divorcée et sans abri quand elle a cherché de l'aide pour la première fois. Elle se souvient encore de ce jour-là où un chauffeur de MSF est venu la chercher.
I was crying. Then he says, I don't know how much feeling, how much pain you feel. And then I cannot say, I cannot tell you it's going to be okay because I don't know for how long have we been living like this. But what I can tell you is just try to be strong.
I also started to be violent on the street with other kids because of what I saw in home. Because of, I saw that my father is feared at home, so I also wanted to be feared on the street. I had anger regarding what happened, what I see when I was growing up. So having this job has changed me in a way that I could see that, no, you know, there's no need in harboring an anger. What's the better way? The better way is to deal with it. So it has changed me a lot. Because of I could see myself on others, my reflection on others. So it helped me a lot.
Hello, le gars aussi.
Le beau raconte qu'il discute avec ses amis de la nécessité de changer les mentalités.
They will listen to you. Some of them they will take what you say. Some of them they will listen to you, but they will not do what you say. Yeah. So it's just a matter of choice. This is my daughter. Her name is Ratlechile, which means we have prospered. She will be 3 years in the 25th of December. She's my Christmas present. Yeah. First thing first, I want to make sure that I secure my little girl's education. Then I need to lead by example of what a good father is, so that when she grew up and has a husband, she could know that okay, if her husband is doing something wrong, she can see that, no, my father didn't teach me this. And this has never happened at home, so it means it's wrong. I want her to be independent. So that's my hope for her, so that she can do whatever she wants. Yeah.
Lebo n'est pas le seul chauffeur de cette équipe à chercher à rompre le cycle de violences sexuelles et sexistes au sein des communautés. Chaque membre de l'équipe participe au changement, en interagissant avec les patientes et en discutant avec ses amis.
When you talk, they listen to you. They don't judge you. They are loving people, really, and they care a lot.